Hello and welcome to This Week from China's National Center for the Performing Arts. I'm your host, George Preston. Inaugurated in 2007, the NCPA is located in the heart of Beijing, adjacent to the Great Hall of the People and Tiananmen Square. Consisting of four main art venues, including an opera house, a concert hall, a theater, and a multifunctional theater, the NCPA is an international platform for the fine arts from China and the world. On our program this week, we'll hear Ravel's Mother Goose Suite, Schubert's Unfinished Symphony No. 8, and Chinese composer BAO Yuankai's folk-infused Drizzle in the South. We'll begin with Ludwig van Beethoven's Symphony No. 8, The Little Symphony in F Major. Beethoven's Eighth may not be known for its symphonic splendor, but it is one of his most autobiographical musical works. One evening, Beethoven attended a dinner party in Vienna with his friend Johann Nepomuk Mälzel, who had recently invented the mechanics of the metronome, a brand new musical timekeeping tool. The device intrigued the dinner guests, Beethoven observed. As the party drifted into the night, the musical entertainment was highlighted by Beethoven's impromptu vocal compositions, accompanied humorously by a steady tick-tock, tick-tock sound from this fascinating new machine. Ta, 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 the metronome. My dear Mälzel, fare thee well, very well, remarked Beethoven. This moment would carry itself all the way into the writing of the Eighth Symphony months later. Here now is conductor LÜ Jia leading the NCPA Orchestra in Beethoven's Symphony No. 8.
Thank you. Thank you.
Beethoven's Symphony No. 8. You heard the NCPA Orchestra conducted by their music director, LÜ Jia. Hello, I'm George Preston, and you're listening to This Week from the National Center for the Performing Arts, or the NCPA. Still to come, Ravel's Mother Goose Suite and Schubert's Symphony No. 8. Before we get to more music, let's hear from the NCPA Orchestra's CEO, Zhen Xiaolong, discussing the purpose and mission of China's National Center for the Performing Arts.
So naturally, as an organization, the NCPA does have some official narratives about its mission and goals. I think that, you know, the NCPA was also born to support the Chinese artist, whether you are a performer, composer, stage director, lighting designer, or an orchestra or a theater company. This is a stage created just for you, and it's our best ever stage on this land. We all know that, you know, artists need the stage and they must have better stage. So they can, you know, get inspired and keep growing if they are given a better stage. So this is what we do, creating and running a home with the best stage for local artists, especially young artists, so we can help foster a better soil and shape a better future for our culture life.
Next, we have a work from Chinese composer BAO Yuankai, Drizzle in the South, from his suite, Chinese Sights and Songs. BAO is one of the most eminent contemporary Chinese composers and music educators. His body of work is as varied as it is large, and he has influenced younger generations of composers for decades. His 1991 work, Chinese Sights and Songs, comprises six suites, each of which is devoted to the folk music of a particular region. BAO's score uses the techniques of Western music as a prism that explores and celebrates the sublime vistas and ancient history of his homeland. The fifth suite, Drizzle in the South, was inspired by folk music of the Jiangsu province. We spoke with conductor CHEN Lin, who led the performance we were about to hear. She is currently a professor at Central Conservatory of Music in Beijing and has conducted the NCPA Orchestra, Shanghai Symphony Orchestra, Beijing Symphony Orchestra, Tanglewood Festival Orchestra, Seiji Ozawa Ongaku Juku Orchestra, Indiana University Symphony Orchestra, and Vancouver Symphony Orchestra. She spoke with us about BAO Yuankai's Drizzle in the South.
While playing BAO Yuankai's Drizzle in the South, the orchestra members need to change their usual ways of playing. For example, the sounds of Chinese traditional instruments might be used in this piece, like erhu, so the violinists need to make the glissando sound more like erhu. The compositions by Chinese composers often feature a number of Chinese elements, whether it's in the opera, orchestral music, or chamber music. The elements can be the pentatonicism of Chinese folk music or short melodies with Chinese characteristics. Just like the Chinese Changsam dress and porcelain, these will remind you of the distinctive Chinese style.
Thank you. BAO Yuankai's Drizzle in the South from his suite, Chinese Sights and Songs. The NCPA Orchestra was conducted by CHEN Lin. Hello, I'm George Preston, and you're listening to This Week from the National Center for the Performing Arts. Coming up in the second part of our program, we'll hear Ravel's Mother Goose Suite and Schubert's Symphony No. 8. This is the WFMT Radio Network, Chicago.
As the music director of the NCPA, I have been involved in launching the Global Chinese Youth Orchestra that's dedicated to training and helping young people to appreciate and enjoy Western classical music. Not important how high level they are, but important the love, the passion, and enjoy the music. That's also from society side. So this is also, for me, is very important because of China's huge population. If we have the young generation, and even by their parents, they involve the passion of the art, then the world will change a lot, and the communication with the world is much easier.
Welcome back to This Week from China's National Center for the Performing Arts. I'm your host, George Preston. You just heard NCPA's Artistic Director of Music, LÜ Jia, speaking about the importance of their Global Chinese Youth Orchestra. He'll lead the NCPA Orchestra in our next work, Maurice Ravel's Ma Mère Loi, or the Mother Goose Suite. Mother Goose is probably one of the world's best-known collections of nursery rhymes. In 1910, Ravel was inspired by these rhymes and composed a childlike and imaginative suite for piano four hands. In 1911, it was adapted into an orchestral version, a kind of musical paradise for the eternally young. The opening Pavane of Sleeping Beauty sets the once-upon-a-time mood for the suite. Next, Tom Thumb becomes lost in the forest and finds that the birds have eaten his trail of breadcrumbs he had left to find his way back home. After that, Chinese Princess Lederonette, Empress of the Pagodas, falls under a curse of ugliness but is rescued by accompaniment from a gamelan-like orchestra of instruments. Then we hear Beauty and the Beast. Beauty sings a light clarinet waltz. The Beast growls coarsely through the contrabassoon. The suite ends with the fairy garden as Ravel bids farewell to this fantastical land. Here now is LÜ Jia leading the NCPA Orchestra in Maurice Ravel's Mother Goose Suite. Ravel's Mother Goose Suite, performed by the NCPA Orchestra under their music director, LÜ Jia. You're listening to This Week from China's National Center for the Performing Arts. Coming up, we'll hear Franz Schubert's Unfinished Symphony No. 8. Written late in 1822, this symphony was lost until the 1860s, when it was discovered in the study of Schubert's friend and fellow composer Anselm Hüttenbrenner. The manuscript contained two fully scored movements and sketches for a third. The two complete movements, plus a final movement from another one of Schubert's works, premiered in 1865, nearly 40 years after Schubert's death. As time went on, the practice of adding another movement to the work stopped. It was clear that the two movements of this piece stand alone. Concertmaster of the NCPA Orchestra, Li Jie, spoke with us about the power of Schubert's music.
Schubert's music is also very powerful. Not like power as Beethoven. Beethoven, you can see the power everywhere. When the first note starts, you'll see the power. But Schubert is different. Schubert's power, you have to use your heart to feel it. Like with oboe, you can see this very fluent, beautiful, solid melody line. But with piece got boom, 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 you feel this kind of power. Schubert's music is very powerful, but it's not from the surface, it's from inner.
Thank you.
The Symphony No. 8 by Franz Schubert. You heard the NCPA Orchestra led by LÜ Jia. We have time for some more music. This is Happiness and Auspice Forever, a concerto for pipa by Zhao Kong. Here now is Liu Xia leading the China National Traditional Orchestra featuring pipa artist Zhao Kong.
Thank you.
We just heard the pipa concerto Happiness and Auspice Forever by Zhao Kong, featuring pipa artist Zhao Kong, the China National Traditional Orchestra led by Liu Xia. And to conclude this week's program, we'll hear Good News from Beijing to the Borderland by Zheng Lu and Ma Hongye. Here is the Beijing Symphony Orchestra led by Tan Lihua. To learn more about China's National Center for the Performing Arts and this program, visit wfmt.com/ncpa. You can find playlists as well as information on future programs. You can also see more from NCPA on their Facebook page, Instagram, and YouTube channel. This week from China's National Center for the Performing Arts is produced by Daniel Goldberg, Rebecca Neistat, and Jan Weller, with production assistance by Maggie Jensen. The executive producers are Jennifer Ho Kwong and George Preston. Special thanks to the media team at the NCPA, including Lu Li, Xi Yingying, Han Jingjing, Fu Jingyi, Tan Lin, and Wei Bohan. And thank you to WFMT's Josh Savageau for his production expertise and to Christina Lin for her vocal talents. Please join us next week as the NCPA presents one of Verdi's most beloved choruses, Va Pensiero Sull'Ali Dorate from Nabucco, Chinese composer Xian Jinghai's imaginative Yellow River Cantata, and Beethoven's Symphony No. 2. I'm your host, George Preston. Thank you for joining us. Stay safe and be well. This week from China's National Center for the Performing Arts is distributed by the WFMT Radio Network, Chicago.